Has playing the same games gotten stale? Looking for a new hobby? Have you thought about making your own game?
You can do that?
Yeah, man.
Hello and welcome to Indi Android. Now, we usually shoot on location, but for obvious reasons, we are not doing that. And as somebody making YouTube videos at home, I'm contractually obligated to do it in front of my shelf of nerd junk. Because in geek culture, ownership equals affection. If you're like me, you need a hobby. And law enforcement told me that screaming at the neighbor kids to keep a 6-foot distance is not a hobby. So, we're gonna try game development. I asked a few local devs their thoughts on how to get started. Here's what they had to say.
It's way different now than it was 15 years ago. So back when I was in college, which was 1996 to 2000, if you wanted to get started in games, you really had to be a hardcore computer engineer. There were no engines. Engines are what we call things you can kind of use to make games. And they come with a bunch of stuff that somebody's already done for you, like displaying graphics on a screen or accepting input. Or arranging things in certain ways. Like, there's a lot of different programs that really help people do that now.
The most repeated tip I got while talking to these guys? Start small.
One of the problems that people have when they first start developing games is they want to make the big thing. Like, they have this giant 50-hour RPG idea in their head.
If you're going to start, think of your idea. You think it's small? Make it smaller. And probably make it smaller again.
Make something that's playable. Find out what people like about it. Make another thing.
But one dev said that's not always the case.
It's wise advice on one hand. I would say the rule that outweighs that is make sure you're making stuff. And so if the only thing you're happy making is something absurdly overscoped and you never finish it, that's fine.
Ian Sundstrom is a developer at Herringbone Studios and just launched Stacks on Stacks on Stacks for PC and Google Stadia. He got his start as an artist before transitioning to game dev.
People actually buy more video games than they buy paintings, so that's been nice.
Once you've decided what kind of game to make, there's no shortage of engines and programs, lots of them free, that can help you make it a reality.
Unity and Unreal, you can download those at home for free, and those have huge communities. Unity is basically the go-to indie tool right now. Some people give it a bad rep just because of like asset flipping games. And that's just kind of a byproduct of it being a free tool. It's a great tool, using it for our project. And there's so many tutorials out there. I couldn't even tell you where to start.
Unity has a bunch of great tutorials just, you know, right on their website. Some of them even come with the engine, and they are a great way to get started really fast.
But Unity and Unreal aren't your only options, not by a long shot.
And I started in an old version of Game Maker, which is an engine that's, you can make all sorts of games with it. It's particularly good at 2D games, and it used to have like a visual scripting sort of thing to help you make sense of it.
What if you're more interested in a narrative-focused game?
Far and away, Twine is the tool that I would use for that. I wish I knew about that earlier. It's code to your comfort level, but you don't have to do any coding at all. You have a very visual branching flowchart interface, and you're basically linking text nodes to each other.
For puzzle games, Nathan recommends PuzzleScript, an open-source engine made by Stephen Lavelle, the dev behind cult favorite Steven Sausage Roll. Still stuck? Ian recommends Sortingh.at, an online quiz from developer Zoe Quinn that recommends game engines based on your interests. No matter what you're making, Cole says it's crucial to find the fun.
The most important thing you can do is get something playable as quick as possible to try and find the fastest route to the fun of your game. If you can make a prototype in 4 hours and show it to someone and they're laughing and having fun with it, then you know you've tapped into something. But if you've put, you know, 100 hours into the narrative of your game, and then, you know, finally 2 months come around and you realize it's not fun, then you wasted a bunch of time.
When you're playing a game, you're looking to go for the flow state, which is the boundary line between boredom and too much frustration. So you're being pushed, like you've got skills, and then the game is like, okay, you must now apply those skills in a more intense environment. And then you get the good feeling, oh yeah, I could do that because I didn't just like hit A, but I hit A at the right time.
Looking at indie success stories, it's easy to get intimidated by the Stardew Valleys or the Undertales and think, there is no way I can make something good by myself. I know this is weird advice for a pandemic, but you don't have to. Rome wasn't built in a day or by one person, and neither was Spelunky.
It's really easy to feel out of your depth. Video games are art piled upon art. There are some people out there in the world who can do everything. But there's lots of free resources right now. So if you're a programmer who doesn't know how to make art, there's lots and lots of free art out there that you can use. You can also find collaborators to work with. If you're only working by yourself, you might have a certain kind of vision, but it really helps to have a diverse amount of viewpoints, which isn't to say make very big teams, make small teams, but as diverse as you can make them, people that aren't like you.
The reality of the thing is that almost every video game ever made has like other people that help out in making it.
If you're getting started, don't feel bad if you just want to copy another game. Like, remake something. Figure out how they did it or put your own spin on it. Scope down, make a character move around, and then think about what would be interesting for that character to do. Work on that a little bit and then step back and think about it. Design is good and important, but sometimes it's best, especially when you're getting started, to just noodle around and see what's interesting.
Use the quarantine to get plugged into forums, subreddits, Discord channels, and make some friends to collaborate with. A good chunk of teamwork in game dev is done remotely anyway, so it won't be that big of an adjustment. Find people who can do the jobs you can't.
Game design was kind of the intersection of a bunch of different interests I had. Like the programming, the math, the writing, the music, everything is necessary because game design is so interdisciplinary. It can absolutely help to get hooked in with some people who are willing to show you the ropes, point you in the right direction. If you're like me and your art is atrocious, then you can find someone else who can really compensate for that deficiency and your games will just be way better for it.
So you've got your idea, you've got an engine to work in, you maybe even have some new teammates. One last bit of advice, take your time.
Everything is going to take longer than you think it will. if it's your first time making anything, of course, just follow a tutorial.
It's just like being patient, really, is probably the biggest thing, and realizing that it's going to take like a lot of time to be able to make your dream game. Like finding something you feel like you can make that you're going to have fun making, and to start learning, I think is really important. And just like getting really good at Google.
And if there's anything we all have a lot of right now, it's time. Get out there to your computer. Please do not leave your home and make some games. Big thanks to Ian, Nathan, Devlin, and Cole for talking with us. For links to their stuff and all the games featured in this video, check the description or WTIU.org/IndieAndroid. And show us what you make. Tweet at me at maybe not Peyton or at WTIU and show off those games. For now, stay home and stay safe.